Well, here we are in Saitama. It's semifinals day at the FIBA World Championship. All those hard practices, all those tough games, it's all coming down to this. These teams need to win two more games to be the world champions. The United States have come here with a great team, but so have the Greeks. And Nikosisis is here to provide an inspirational support following his serious injury, where he had three bones broken in his face in a game against Brazil in Hamamatsu. The Saitama Arena has been rocking ever since we got here. And Japan is buzzing as well about the sport. You better believe that this is going to be the peak of the competition. I'm not sure there's ever been four teams gathered like this for the semifinals. The United States team has numerous players like Shane Battier, Dwayne Wade, Dwight Howard, Carmelo Anthony, LeBron James, you name it, all the way down. Most of you will be aware of them and their exploits in the NBA. For the Greeks, well, they've got Theodoros Papaloukas, Theo, Sofoklis Chortsianidis, Nikosisis, who isn't playing with that injury, Spanoulis, Vassilopoulos, Antonis Vatsis, Hatsovertis, Demos Dikoudis, Kostas Tsitsaras, Dimitris Diamantidis, Lazarus Papadopoulos, and the captain, Mihailis Kakouzias. And they're coached by Panyatis Yanakis. The Greek fans, this is what they've been waiting for ever since the groups were announced. They knew that they would not play the U.S. until they got to the knockout round. And as both finished top of their groups, they have made it this far to the semifinals before they've met. We're going to hear the national anthems for both teams. Well, that was the national anthem from the United States. Now we're going to hear from Greece. They are the European champions. Well, Panyatis Yanakis will go to midcourt, shake hands with his good friend, Mike Krzyzewski, the coach of Team USA. Both played the game. Krzyzewski followed up a collegiate career at West Point and coached that team, the military academy, before going on to take over Duke. They were struggling at Duke University before Mike Krzyzewski got there. Now 25 years later, they are one of the powerhouses in the game. Kurt Heinrich will start along with LeBron James, Carmelo Anthony, Elton Brand, and Joe Johnson here against the Greeks. I'm not sure what you can read into that with Heinrich playing instead of Chris Paul. Joe Johnson's had some good moments defensively. Elton Brand is a big body down low. For Greece, well, it all starts up at the top with Diamantidis, the best defensive player in Europe. Also lining up at guard, Hatzavertis, the captain Kikuzis at power forward, well, small forward, and Antonis Fatsis and Lazaros Papadopoulos. Fatsis can drift outside, hit the three. Most of these Greeks can step outside and hit the three, possibly the exception of Papadopoulos. We spoke about Mike Krzyzewski. He went to West Point. He's loving this, representing his country. He was an assistant with Team USA, the original dream team, to Chuck Daly at the Barcelona Olympics. 14 years later, here he is. For the legend in Greece, it's Panayotis Yannakis, who was the point guard on that Greek basketball team that shocked European basketball by upsetting the Soviet Union. Since then, he has come and he has now led Greek, written some new pages in Greek basketball history as the coach of this national team. Two minutes away from the start of the semifinal, the other will be Argentina and Spain. So whoever wins this game, rest assured it will not be easy to capture the gold. I think this is a watershed moment for international basketball as we take a look at the referees from Italy, Brazil, and Serbia-Montenegro. Never before, by my recollection, have you ever had four teams of such quality make it this far into a Final Four. I think most people would say this thing is wide open. Any one of these four teams can win this tournament, and for different reasons. The talent in the U.S. team is something to behold, but so is the teamwork and the experience in the Greek side and the self-belief, and also the addition of Shortsenidis there, the big fella, 6 feet, 9 inches tall, 125 kilogram. So there are a lot of options. The loss of Nikos Isis does hurt Greece, make no mistake, if they have to try to bust the zone. But the United States here in Saitama, they've looked very difficult to beat. If they hit their shots from outside, they're going to be very, very tough to deal with. Yannakis, determined, went unbeaten in Group C, the group of death in Hamamatsu, where they had to play teams like Australia, Brazil, Lithuania, Turkey, and Qatar. The United States have arrived here in Saitama after winning in Group D. They took on teams like Puerto Rico, Italy, China, Senegal, and Slovenia. Italy did lead the United States at halftime by 9 points, and they went up by as many as 12 at the start of the second half, but the United States won comfortably in the end. Well, the teams shake hands at midcourt before the jump. Papadopoulos has played the game at Dynamo Moscow. He's going to be jumping up against the former Duke player, Elton Brand, who's now with the LA Clippers. So United States picking up full court here. Heinrich guarding Diamantidis. Hatsavertas comes out, guarded by Joe Johnson. Kukuzius. Fotsis. Shot clock to 9. The defense is already pretty intense here for the United States. The block. Hatsavertas pulls up at the free throw line and gets it blocked by Brand. Excellent start by the United States. James left open for a 3. Bounces out into the corner. Over to Anthony. Off the backboard, the United States getting some open looks. Fotsis. Entry pass to Papadopoulos. And the hook shot from the big fella. And that's important. It's good to see Papadopoulos get on track. Don't forget, the United States faced Greece at the Athens Olympics in 2004, and it was a very close game. Now, this is a different U.S. team with the exception of Anthony, Wade, and James. Nice drive by Carmelo Anthony. So the foul on Papadopoulos. Carmelo Anthony makes the first. His emergence with this U.S. team has been incredible to watch. So Anthony of the Denver Nuggets, and he played for Syracuse, led them to a national title in college. His college coach is actually an assistant to Mike Krzyzewski, Jim Boeheim. Diamantidis. Kukuzius, Fotsis, Hatsavertas looks a little shaky up against Joe Johnson. Shot clock to 4. Once again, Hatsavertas is going to have to shoot it and doesn't get the shot off in time. So poor execution on offense from Nikos Hatsavertas. Intriguing battle of an experienced Greek team who pride themselves on defense. Up against a very talented but young American side. Diamantidis, and he's fouled as he goes past Kurt Heinrich. So the United States fell asleep. That last trip down, Elton Brand had the ball knocked away. The United States have had some close games at times. We mentioned Italy were leading them at halftime by 9 points. They only led Germany 40-39 at halftime. And Kukuzius has the ball knocked away by Anthony, who I think has been the United States' best player at the FIBA World Championship. To a wide open Kurt Heinrich. Well, that was the strategy of Germany. That was the strategy of Australia, and Kukuzius down the middle. The strategy of those teams was to allow the United States those open looks where they've struggled in past international tournaments. Offensive rebounding has been a problem for a lot of the teams that play the United States. This is exciting. Don't you know, in the United States right now, people looking in possibly sense the intensity level of this tournament has just gone up a notch. And in Athens, anywhere in Greece, people are tuning in to watch this showdown. Very intriguing battle. Papadopoulos going up against Elton Brand, and this time gets it blocked. Good defense by Greece, and Hatsavertas is going to go in for the dunk. And James chased him, tried to get the block, but Greece's defense has already created a couple of opportunities here. Fotsis physically, the Greeks look like they match up better against the United States than some of their other opponents. And look at the offensive rebound from the United States and Elton Brand. Wow. I repeat, this is a watershed moment for international basketball. This game and the next one that follows. What a day it's going to be here in Saitama. The level of play from both sides looks like it's going to be very high. It's just so even. Diamantidis. Guarded by Heinrich. Over to Hatzovertis. Papadopoulos had his last shot blocked by Brand. And he's pushed and he's fouled by Elton Brand. Papadopoulos has raised a few eyebrows at the Olympics, but even more so in this tournament. His game has improved, his footwork, which is so key for a big man. Kikuzius of Barcelona. Over to Papadopoulos again, the double team. Kikuzius left open for the three, off the front of the rim. .538 to go, Anthony drives down, fouled as he entered the lane. Think he's enjoying himself? So the foul called on Lazaros Papadopoulos, two cheap fouls. Chris Paul, who had been starting at point guard, comes in for the United States. And big Sofakis Shortsenidis, who's really captured the attention of everybody, not only because of his size, that big frame. He's already been drafted, by the way, by the Clippers, so he could end up being a teammate of Elton Brand one day. But not only the size, but the play of Shortsenidis has really been something to behold here in this tournament. Anthony makes both free throws, so the United States have made all four of their free throws so far. The United States back on top, 7-6. Hatzovertis guarded closely by Johnson. Diamantidis, shot clock to 8. And good rebound by the Greeks, good defense, and then Chris Paul steals it away. And the United States are going to get an open look. Nine to six, the United States. The depth on this Greek team, or this U.S. team, and Shortsenidis goes up strong. Second foul called against Elton Brand. So he has to go to the seat. He has to go to the bench. It's been an intriguing situation with Shortsenidis because he's such a big body. Even Yao Ming had a hard time stopping him. Timeout on the floor. The United States leading 9-6 here in the semifinal at the FIBA World Championship. Red Foxes are dancing to I Will Survive. We'll have to see which one of these two teams does survive this semifinal. Three of seven from the field for Greece, just two of seven for the United States, but they're 4-4 at the free throw line. Well, that was Mike D'Antoni, who is offering some tactics, some scenarios for the United States when they've got the ball. D'Antoni coached in Europe, played in Europe for a long time with Olympia Milano. Now the very successful coach with the Phoenix Suns. Dwight Howard into the game. Asking, I think, about how you're allowed to guard the big guy, Shortsenidis. Shortsenidis doesn't give away much in terms of size against any of these Americans. In fact, he doesn't give anything away. He gives something away in inches, height, certainly not in strength and girth. Shortsenidis spent last season playing with Olympiakos in Greece. They had a very good season. He had kind of a breakout season with them. He'll be with them again next season. Dwayne Wade also into the game, number 8. He's a crowd favorite. LeBron James, and strong move, LeBron James. Nice play by the Ohio native. Plays now with Cleveland. One of the tri-captains in this team. Vasilios Spanoulis has come in, number 7. He's got the ball. He'll be going up against all these players next year in the NBA, playing with the Houston Rockets, just signed for them. Diamantidis fouled by Dwayne Wade. Oh, goodness me. So this deal, I'd like to see that again. Dwayne Wade knocked it away, and that was LeBron James. What can he not do is the question. Wow. Diamantidis makes the first one. United States have truly represented themselves well here in Japan. They've built a program. And it all starts at the top with Jerry Colangelo, the executive director, Mike Krzyzewski, D'Antoni, Jim Boeheim. They've really set the tone. Nate McMillan, they're a class act. LeBron James, and it goes to Dwight Howard. So the U.S., who had been shooting some jumpers, suddenly finding their way to the basket. We've heard so much about the Greek defense, but giving away easy opportunities. The lead is 4. Shot clock to 8. Open to Fatsis, passed up to 3. Ball knocked out of bounds by Carmelo Anthony, but the U.S. defense isn't giving anything away right now. And I think, unfortunately for Carmelo Anthony, he has to take a seat after making a big play. It's the one problem you've got in this U.S. team. There's so many good players, and you got to keep them happy. Spanoulis for 3. Oh, and he banks it in. Did he call backboard? I don't think so. But it's noted that the Greek shots, some of them are rushed because of that quick defense by the Americans. Wide open, LeBron James, another offensive rebound, and the dunk by Dwight Howard. And the Greeks already have a problem on the offensive rebounds. The United States out-rebounding them 7-3, and on the offensive glass, they've got 3 rebounds. Cross-court to Hatzivertis for 3. And Shortsenidis goes up for the rebound, has the ball knocked away by Dwight Howard, who's made a big impact on the game. Dwayne Wade for 3. Shortsenidis battles, and again, offensive rebound, Dwight Howard. Not much the Greeks can do. They're going to have to do a little bit better job getting a body on him. Well, Hatzivertis has checked out, and the leader of this team, Theo Papaloukas, who comes off the bench, has checked in. Howard makes the first one. Howard has come in off the bench. He's got 5 points, 2 of two of two from the floor. Misses the second one, but another offensive rebound in Dwayne Wade. 18 to 12. So the offensive boards, you know about the defense, and it's also the offensive rebounding. It's really hurting the Greeks right now. The United States up to their biggest lead of the game, 18 to 12. Turnover, Papaloukas. Dwayne Wade carries in the lane, has it knocked away, but gets it back. Wide open, Shane Battier in the corner. And this time over the back, it's Chris Bosch. Mike Krzyzewski giving the referee an earful, didn't care for that call. Schwarzenegger is taking that opportunity to offer some instruction to his players, and the referee went over and motioned to him to let them get back on the court. Konstantinos Tsitsaris coming in. Fotsis makes both shots, comes out. Fotsis had a great game against the U.S. at the Olympics. He comes out. Chris Paul, Tsitsaris into the corner to Shane Battier. It's not been the shooting that's killed the Greeks right now. It's been the offensive rebounds. They've got five so far, the Americans. Dwayne Wade drifts into the corner. And he is just magical, Dwayne Wade, watching him with the ball. A lot of comparisons made between Dwayne Wade and Michael Jordan after he led the Miami Heat to the NBA title this season with that 4-2 series victory over Dirk Nowitzki and the Dallas Mavericks. Wade was phenomenal. And he is one of the players with Carmelo Anthony and LeBron James who played on that Olympic team in Athens. Where the Americans won the bronze medal. Greece lost to eventual champions Argentina in a very close quarterfinal. Spanoulis gets the pick. Tsitsaris passed up the three. And Tsitsaris. Just 4 seconds on the shot clock. United States. Block Spanoulis as he goes in. Chris Paul. Foul on Theo Papaloukas. So Wade missed those two free throws, but Chris Paul, the NBA Rookie of the Year, went to Wake Forest. He makes one of two, but another offensive rebound given away by Greece, and it's killing them right now. Bosch out on the perimeter, Chris Paul. Greece in a 2-3 zone. Here's Chris Paul, shot clock to five. And another offensive rebound. The United States should have tapped that in. They had two players right at the rim. Tsitsaris. Spanoulis.
Diamantidis drives and almost had a chance for a three-point play, but doesn't make it. Look at that. How did the United States not come away with points on that possession? I saw four hands up there, and they were all American. Greece, in their first game in this tournament, trailed Qatar 28-12 and came back and beat them rather soundly. Greece 5 of 7 from the line. If I remember correctly, it was 20 points they came back to win that game by. So it's a 5-point lead. Costly misses. Penetration, foul, charge called against Dwayne Wade. Good call. I mean, it's one of those, it's going to be called. Dwayne Wade did not like it. U.S. having to bite their tongue, having to bite their lip, not say anything. Schwarzenegger comes out. Fotsis, Tsitsaras, Spanoulis, Papaloukas, and Diamantidis all in the game. So Fotsis is big. He'll play at a power forward position. And Tsitsaras, the big man. United States don't want Greece to run down the clock here at the end, but Greece want to hold it for one shot. Fotsis from the corner gets it swatted, and the foul called on Chris, on Fotsis, reaching over for Chris Bosch. So what a play by Chris Bosch. So interesting how defense gives you opportunities. That time, fantastic effort by Chris Bosch. United States now 6 of 11 from the free throw line. They're out-rebounding Greece 13-6. Theo Papaloukas doesn't have much time. Puts up a three, bricks it. So he got a good shot. Greece trailed 20-14. At the end of the first quarter in this semifinal at the FIBA World Championship here in Saitama. Well, there have been some good moments for Greece in this game, and there have been some dynamic moments from the United States, but we've come to expect that from them. The offensive rebounding is something that I don't know what you can do if you're Greece, because those Americans are so quick, big, agile, strong. It's very difficult to keep them off the offensive glass. That tells the story right there. 6 offensive rebounds for the United States. Thank you. United States started off here in the second quarter. LeBron James back in, Carmelo Anthony on the baseline. It's a short one for James, and now it's their biggest lead, 22-14. Bounce pass, Papadopoulos. Banks it in. Coach K wanting to travel, but no call. 22-16. Papadopoulos takes his tally in this game to 4 points and a charge called against LeBron James. LeBron James, just 21 years old. Spanoulis. Spanoulis pulls up for three and blocked, shooting a three by LeBron James, who, if you read lips, you'll notice they won't be too happy about that call. Greece 5 of 8 from the free throw line right now. Spanoulis makes the second one. Seen a lot of players fouled behind the arc in this tournament, a lot of the games. So Spanoulis makes him pay, converts all three, it's back to a 3-point game. Spanoulis guarding Paul. Carmelo Anthony, guarded by Tsitsaris in the corner, Greece in a 2-3 zone. James over to Anthony, shot clock to 5, Anthony, count it. United States looking for those shots close to the basket. Anthony so far been able to knock down a couple of jumpers. He's got 8 points. Papadopoulos, spin move the other way, throws it over the basket, and the rebound again goes to the Americans. Bounce pass, oh, and just like that, LeBron James. And that is entertaining stuff. And the crowd appreciates it, 26-19. Greece, I can't see Greece winning this game if they don't improve the rebounding situation. They're just getting dominated right now. Spanoulis dishes, and good play by Spanoulis to dump it to Papadopoulos. The foul on Dwight Howard. Heinrich, Elton Brand back in, and James, after that great fast break dunk, has to sit down. Looks like both teams fired up for this one, especially the United States. They want to get out and run. But right now, they're out rebounding Greece 14-6. Anthony, way too easy for the United States, drifting into the lane. Over wide open, Diamantidis dishes to Papadopoulos. Ball knocked away by Anthony. It's showtime. Turnovers and fast breaks. Points in the paint for the United States, 16 Anthony has a game-high 12 points for the U.S. Papadopoulos. And a charge called against Papadopoulos. Timeout, Greece. They want to talk about it. Trailing 30-21 here in the second quarter against the United States. Well, that U.S. shooting percentage has gone right up there, and it's because they're getting those steals and fast breaks, easy shots. Also, Anthony finding his range, right, drifting into the lane, stopping and popping. Greece need to pick it up on defense, start playing a little more sense of urgency here against the United States. Joe Johnson from the corner. The lead goes to 12 for the United States against the European champions. Papaloukas dishes to Papadopoulos. Well, the U.S. are dropping off to double team, and Greece are having players open. Greece now back in a 2-3. Johnson just hit one. And that's a rare occurrence, a Greek rebound. Takes him up to 7 for the game. The U.S. have twice as many. Entry pass, Anthony out of bounds. Kikuzias. I don't think there's any question that Carmelo Anthony is the leader of this team and has been the best player, both offensively and defensively. He's been amazing. Papaloukas to Kikuzias, who's guarded by Shane Battier in the corner. Shot clock to 2. Spanoulis puts up a long one again, and that USA defense not allowing Greece to get involved in any of their sets. Kurt Heinrich up and down. Tried the dribble. 7 turnovers for the United States, 6 for Greece, but it's the rebounds and really the U.S. scoring off those turnovers by Greece that's made the difference. And it goes to Big Shaq, Baby Shaq, and he missed the dunk. Oh, and he gets swatted by Diamantidis. Chris Paul, see if that lifts the Greeks. Spanoulis for 3, wide open. And fouled by Kurt Heinrich. The second time Spanoulis has been fouled while shooting a 3-pointer. You just have to love the way the U.S. play the game. They are just playing at a frenetic pace. They're fast, quick, but Greeks trying to hang with them right now, down by 10 points. I would think so far that Greece have been able to play at a tempo which is acceptable to them. They certainly don't want to run with the U.S. What they have to do is cut down on their turnovers and once again figure out a way to start boxing out the Americans, preventing them from getting those offensive boards. Greece fall back in a 2-3 zone again. Howard, Heinrich in the corner. Chris Paul penetrates Kurt Heinrich. A long three and rebound, and this allows Theo Papaloukas to run. Kicks it over to Diamantidis, who scores, and Greece get a transition basket. Kurt Heinrich. Greece back in a 2-3. And good defense by Diamantidis, and the crowd appreciate the effort from Greece. I'd be surprised if we didn't see Demos Tekoudis in this game. I just can't see. He didn't play in the last one for Greece, and I think he's got the type of game that could leave with the United States. Joe Johnson, guarded by Baby Shaq, is what he's called. And Spanoulis looked to run. Schwarzenegger missed that two-handed dunk. Theo Papaloukas goes all the way. Theo Papaloukas, and Greece have fought back and trail 33-30. Nice little run by Greece, and the United States are going to get a timeout and talk about it. Theo Papaloukas, the most valuable player of the EuroLeague Final Four this year with CSKA Moscow. And he was at it right here, driving in. Papaloukas always comes off the bench for club or country. And he doesn't really care about anything except winning. He doesn't care who scores the points. He just wants to win, but he does tend to raise his game for the important occasions. That was his first basket of the game. US have 16 rebounds, 10 for Greece. 13 of 16 at the line for Greece right now. That's helping keeping them in the line and in the game. LeBron James pulls up, another offensive rebound for the United States, and he goes up and he's going to get a chance for a three-point play. Dwight Howard has been an animal on the boards all day long. And just like that, the United States come back and kill the Greeks where they've been hurting them all day long. And he makes the free throw. Mm-hmm. Diamantidis for three. Count it. Well, the Greeks in a heavyweight battle right now like they haven't faced in this entire FIBA World Championship. And Dwight Howard, some of the self-belief growing in the Greek team. No question about it. You can feel it. Up ahead to big man Stratsinidis for the dunk. And just like that, it's 36-35. And the United States know they've got a game on their hands. Chris Paul, the block called against Spanoulis. There won't be any panic whatsoever, but what you're going to see as Stratsinidis goes up on the fast break, you're going to see Carmelo Anthony check back into the game, and Dwayne Wade is going to have a seat. Spanoulis now has two fouls. Carmelo Anthony back into the game. He's been the Americans' best player. Kind of a soft foul given away by Spanoulis. They call him Sofo, Stratsinidis. Sofo is short for Sophocles. Thought there was an earthquake yesterday, 4.8 on the Richter scale here in Saitama. We thought it was Stratsinidis walking into the arena, but it was indeed an earthquake. He's a big man. Kikuzius with the foul. So the next one that Greece commit will put Team USA on the line. James. Johnson back to James in the corner to Paul. Johnson works it inside. Chris Paul for the dunk. So Chris Bosh, I mean, so good patience by the United States. Spanoulis. And it goes to big Stratsinidis again. And Greece are finding their big man in the low post. And good defense by Greece, and it's going to go out of bounds to the Greeks. And Kurt Heinrich is going to come back into the game, and he's going to spell LeBron James, possibly give the United States a little bit better ball handling. If Greece hit the shot here and take the lead, this Saitama Super Arena is going to absolutely explode. And it goes to Baby Shaq, and he scores! Greece have taken the lead. Stratsinidis, 39-38, Greece. And it looked like the U.S. are going to run away with it for a while there in the first half, and Greece have been hanging around. Chris Paul drives in. Looked like he got tripped, but there's no call. Diamantidis, Kikuzis, bounce pass back to Diamantidis. And here he is again, Stratsinidis, and they don't have an answer for Sophocles Stratsinidis. The referee tells Papaloukas to get up. Another turnover forced by the Greeks, and Papaloukas has the ball. Spanoulis. Papaloukas drives in, hits the layup right before the expiration of the shot clock, and we've got a timeout by the United States, who trail 43-38, their biggest deficit of the game. This has been some run by the Greeks here in the second quarter. Well, 8 of those 10 points in that key 10-2 run by Greece, scored by Schwartzianidis. Greeks have stepped up their defense, extending it, and penetration into the lane, Chris Paul. And to combat that D, the United States have Heinrich in the game, so he's going to pop out. Chris Paul with 2 shots. So that makes it 43-40. See if that calms things down for the United States. Spanoulis, 23 seconds left in the half. About a 7-second differential on the shot clock. Papaloukas goes up with the left hand. He scores it. Back to a 5-point lead. The United States have 8 seconds left here to chip into that lead, chip into that deficit. Oh, and it's blocked by Tsitsouras. Anthony was going up for the two-handed jam, and it was blocked by Tsitsouras. And the reason why they call that foul is because it's a sweeping motion. So Greece have 3.4 seconds left. They're going to talk about how they want to set it up here at the end of the first half to get a shot. All these points are vital. Spine-tingling stuff, this U.S. team in a game right now. 45-40, Carmelo Anthony at the line. He's led the United States today with 12 points. He's also been awesome on the defensive end with 2 steals, and he's come away with a rebound. I think the USA could be trailing by 10 points with a minute to go, and there'd be no panic in their eyes. But certainly the self-belief has grown a little bit here in the Greek team in the first half. Greece will want to get a shot before the end of the half, but they'll also make sure not to throw the ball into the hands of the U.S. A long one, Diamantidis. Well, I think if you'd ask Greece what they'd like at halftime, if possible, 45-41, they'd take it. They went on that run at the end of the first half, Schwartzianidis scoring 8 straight points for the Greeks. And they lead it by 4 against the United States. It's what we expected. It wasn't just the hype. These guys can play, the European champions taking on the United States of America. Both teams unbeaten in the FIBA World Championship. After today, one of them will not be. Well, that shooting percentage from Greece has just shot way up, 13 of 19, and a lot of that's because getting the good shots to Schwartzianidis inside and also the layups. United States 12 of 21. Free throws, the Greeks have an advantage. The rebounds, So far, the United States are dominating in that category. 13 points for Anthony, leads all scorers, but it's the Greeks who lead this one on the scoreboard, and that's where it matters. They're in front 45-41.
total?
You know, after the way they came back from down 12, they can do anything.
Yeah.
I think so too. It's,
when they were down 12, I was worried.
Yeah.
Rebounding's an issue, but.
They lost a few offensive rebounds, and they more of a block. And even with Papa Dupla at 3 fouls, that really hurt them, but they're still up 4.
Yeah.
And they're scoring a lot more than they normally would because they play faster than they normally would. It's just amazing adaptability to me. Okay, here's the situation. Well, let's do something different, you know? Able to do it. Papaloukas.
Well, it's about to, to have to be able to recognize it by Papaloukas. I mean,
yeah,
it's incredible when he's got the ball.
Motion too.
I know.
He's like, and he just sees exactly where the opening is and just sort of trots in there. But it's great basketball. And he's like Magic Johnson with that long pass in the axe of the bucket there.
But he knows also, he's comfortable going to his left hand, isn't he, under the basket? I think Americans, they just want to run. They want to go, they want to attack. And I think it really kills them to have to, like, sit back and try to
play against a passing zone.
Yeah.
If they never make their threes, then they're going to have a long 7 and a half. You know, you're obliged to have an American team to shoot threes.
Yeah.
Or at least outside shots. Way lost confidence in his shot. He looks terrible.
Yeah. No, I think Heinrich is pretty confident.
He
I assume that's why they put him in.
He's shooting 38. He's shooting 66%. He should be taking more threes too.
Okay, so now, okay.
The other day, they together. Heinrich and Battier.
Yeah. But the other day, Australia, they got hot. Okay, now maybe struggling a little bit.
It's
Let's
a lot
see how they
defense,
hit
them. Australia's defense is sucking.
Yeah.
If it's not a running game, they're going to have a lot harder time.
Well, just glad. I was like you. I was like, you can just see they called a timeout freeze. And you know, I just must have really
Well, they went back. They went to a zone.
Yeah.
They lost a few rebounds, but then they solved that problem, too.
Yeah. What's that? Did you go to a baseball game?
No, Harlem. Like, Harlem.
All right.
Preview that we did, you know? It was like we were identifying the, and then today, Papaloukas.
to interview. Go to interviews. Yeah. I was there, I just saw it.
Well, in 30 seconds, we're going to start the second half here. USA trailing Greece 45-41 in the semifinal of the FIBA World Championship. Greece trailed by 12 points, but they came back. It's the big man, Sofoklis Chortzianidis from Olympiakos, just 21 years old, 6 feet 9 inches, 125 kilograms. He's a lot of power. He scored 8 straight points for Greece as they went on a 10-2 run to go up by 5. Now it's a 45-41 lead for Chortzianidis and co. And Papaloukas is going to start the second half. Fotsis. Papadopoulos has those 3 fouls for Greece, the center. So Chortzianidis does start. Diamantidis in the lane, hits it. So a good start for Greece here, 47-41. We've been talking to the Greek journalists at halftime, and they say everybody is watching this game back in Greece. A lot of people taking the day off. It's quite an event. The European champions last year beating Germany in the final in Belgrade. Strong move, good patience for the United States. Dwight Howard and Carmelo Anthony have been easily the best players for the U.S. today. Very difficult to contain. Carmelo Anthony on Fotsis, Heinrich, Spanoulis. Spanoulis goes around and draws the foul on Heinrich. And Panayotis Yannakis wanting an unsportsmanlike foul because he wasn't anywhere close to the ball. Spanoulis will get to play against Heinrich next year in the NBA, having decided to leave Panathinaikos and go ahead and sign with the Houston Rockets, the team that drafted him. And it's Fotsis for 3. The lead is their biggest of the game now, 50-43. Heinrich for 3. Count it. Team USA battle back. No panic. That's why he's in there. Heinrich can nail that 3. Papaloukas over to Fotsis. Into the lane, gets up, and he's going to have a chance for a 3-point play. Draws the foul from Carmelo Anthony. And so far, Greece not showing any signs of cracking against this very talented American team. And Mike Krzyzewski, I won't say it's a worried look. He's been in a lot of big games in his career, but I think he knows that he's in a battle here in the semifinal of the FIBA World Championship. The United States having been knocked out in the quarterfinals in Indianapolis 4 years ago. And 2 years ago,
These two teams met at the Olympics, which the United States won, and USA went on to win the bronze medal. But with USA, that's not good enough. They want to win the gold. They're going to have to get by a tough Greek team. And a foul called on Shortsenidis, number 5. Who moved in too late. So there'll be free throws coming up for Carmelo Anthony, who's been such a fantastic player here in Japan. He has really taken to the role of captain, one of three captains with Dwayne Wade and LeBron James. And for my money, Carmelo Anthony's been the man. Mike Krzyzewski. Things weren't working for Greece, playing man-to-man. They went to the zone, started getting a few opportunities in transition. They got Big Sofo involved. And the next thing you know, they're in front. Anthony misses both free throws. The Americans, 11 of 19 from the line, 58%. Do not adjust your set. Greece are leading 52-46 here early in the third quarter. Spanoulis. And to Shortsenidis, who was blocked and gets the rebound and puts it up. 54-46 now, their biggest lead of the game, Greece. 8 points. Anthony penetrates, drives, and it's a captain's drive for Carmelo Anthony. They fall asleep, the Americans. Shortsenidis goes up for the snowbird. It's back to a 56-48 lead. Chris Paul over to James. He gets swatted by Baby Shaq. Oh, this is terrific stuff. Just to see the efforts of both of these teams. That was a hard foul on LeBron James, who's had a few of those in his career. Dwayne Wade into the game. Elton Brand takes his place in the lineup as well. So Wade, Brand, James, Paul, and Carmelo. 8-point lead. U.S. free throw shooting leaves a little bit to be desired at this point. 11 of 20. This is both. And USA get the rebound. And Dwayne Wade is fouled by Shortsenidis. And that means he's going to have, he's asking to stay in. That's three fouls on Shortsenidis. And I don't think Giannakis wants to take a chance. He's going to bring his big guy out of the game. If there's one area where the United States is killing Greece, it's on the offensive glass. 9 offensive rebounds for the USA. Shortsenidis checks out. He's got 13 points to lead Greece. Now, this Greek team won the European title last year in Belgrade. It is a better team, a year older, but also with the addition of Shortsenidis, he wasn't there. Dwayne Wade. These guys have seen it all with their clubs in the U.S., but the international game is a little bit different. They're not familiar at all with these Greek players. Diamantidis. Tsitsaras guarded by Brand. Spanoulis works against Paul. Shot clock down to 7. Spanoulis for 3. Count it! Spanoulis takes the lead to 9. The biggest lead. Anthony fouled by Fotsis. Fotsis says he didn't touch him, and that's a big call. Because Fotsis, with that foul, well, that's his second. Actually, the foul called on Spanoulis. Looked like he'd called the trip. Looked like he'd called the trip on Fotsis. How are the United States going to react to being behind by 9 points More than 3 minutes into the second half. Dimas Dekoudis, a big, powerful forward, checks into the game for Greece. James for three. Rebound. The smallest guy on the floor for Greece. Spanoulis. Diamantidis. Tsitsaras. Diamantidis for three. Count it. He hits it. They feel it right now. Greece have taken a 62-50 lead. If they didn't believe it at halftime, they sure believe now, because the USA are struggling against the European champions. Third foul to Tsitsaras. The Greeks getting hot, hitting some three-pointers now. They've got 5 of 11 for the game. And the free throw shooting woes for the United States continue. Well, Hatzovertis. And it's Tsitsaras joins the three-point shooting barrage. This is remarkable. Greece lead at 65-51. Chris Paul, and it goes, a dunk by Dwayne Wade. Greece are 6 of 12 from three-point range. At halftime, they were 2 of 8. Entry pass to Dekoudis, and he makes it. And Papaloukas spots Dekoudis. And Greece have gone back on top, 67-53. The Saitama Arena is going nuts over the European champions. The no-look pass to Dekoudis. I can't imagine what's happening right now in Athens and all over Greece, where this Greek team is showing they're for real against the USA. Well, that three-pointer by Konstantinos Tsitsaras took that lead to 14 points, 67-53. Greece just 2 of 8 from the arc in the first half. They're now 6 of 12. No panic whatsoever on the faces of the United States. There is a long way to go in this one, but I don't think there's any question that, again, the confidence has grown in the Greek team. Wade penetrates, drives, foul on Tsitsaras. That's now 4 fouls on Tsitsaras. Kakuzi is going to come back in, so So Kukuzius and Dekutis need to give some big minutes here for Greece, going up against that powerful front line of the U.S. Well, actually, it's only Brand in the game right now for the big guys. USA, 15 of 26 from the line, 58%. It's been one of their problems. And Wade sinks both of them. The lead is 12. Dekutis. Diamantidis, guarded closely by Paul. He finds Dekutis, who goes up strong. And that American defense extending and the double team gives the Greeks the open man in the lane. You get double teamed, somebody's got to be open. Carmelo Anthony for three. Carmelo Anthony, 18 points already. He leads all scorers. Point lead. Diamantidis, and it goes. Papaloukas, the follow by Dekutis, is given some good minutes off the bench. USA with a chance to break. Elton Brand into the hands of Greece. Papaloukas. Oh, and he finds Dekutis wide open, blocked by the U.S. But Kukuzius chases down the rebound, and Greece pull it back out. Spine-tingling stuff. Papaloukas, and the lane goes up, misses the layup. Good rebound by James. Here come the Americans. Anthony for three, good! 71-61. 3:16 to play in the third. Diamantidis, fouled by Chris Paul. Melo with that three-pointer took his tally to 21 points for the game. 2 of 3 from three-point range, 5 of 5 inside the arc, 5 of 8 from the line. He is carrying this team. He's playing with confidence, Carmelo Anthony, and his team desperately need him right now. 71-61. Hatzivertis over to Papaloukas. Diamantidis, Dekutis. Gets his man off the glass, off his feet, Wade. And Dekutis goes in with a bank shot. Heinrich crosses midcourt over to Anthony again, who is open. Misses that three, but the long rebound in the corner to the United States and James. Heinrich, Greece still in the 2-3 zone. Anthony guarded by Papaloukas. Papaloukas knocks it out of bounds. 12 seconds on the shot clock. 2:21 to go here in the third quarter. Wade in the corner. Anthony. Offensive rebound, the battle of Battier. Battling Battier, and it comes out to Greece. And oh, Battier scraps and gets it back for the USA. Anthony. Shane Battier hustling on the floor. It's why he's in this squad. Gives his team a defensive spark. Papaloukas. Kukuzius on the baseline. He hits it. And right now, Greece are just on fire offensively. They are shooting 62% inside the arc. Wade kicks it out. Joe Johnson, Battier with the rebound and the foul called on Diamantidis. Before the shot, Shane Battier lifting his teammates. Timeout on the floor. Substitution. Diamantidis, Hatzavertis out. Fatsis back in with Spanoulis, along with Papaloukas, Kikouzis, and Dekoudis, who's been huge in limited action. 6 points, 8 points for Dekoudis. The Greeks talking in Greek, so the Americans can't understand them. And Battier off the back of the rim. It's a 12-point lead for Greece. Both of these teams undefeated in this tournament. It is truly a heavyweight showdown. USA won Group D. Greece won Group C. In Hamamatsu. The Americans were in Sapporo. Spanoulis. Since the double team might be coming. 8 seconds. Spanoulis pulls up, gets blocked by Battier. The quick jumper, Battier. Johnson kicks it to Heinrich. Over goes to Wade in the lane. Draws the foul on Dekoudis. Excellent play by the United States. And once again, it's Shane Battier. Shane Battier started it with that block shot. Two blocks for Shane Battier, two rebounds. And he's hustling all over the place. When the United States put this team together, the free throw shooting woes continue. When the United States put this team together, they put together a team of versatility, of players to fill certain roles. Battier was the one player they had to play that lockdown defense, and it's paying dividends today. The lead is now 10. Good training for Spanoulis as he gets ready for his rookie NBA campaign with the Houston Rockets. I don't think he's thinking about that right now. Papaloukas. And a foul called on Battier. Very strange. Must have. Shane Battier played for Mike Krzyzewski at Duke University along with Elton Brand. Brand on the bench. Fatsis, Spanoulis. I'm a little surprised Dwight Howard's not on the floor because he's been so effective. 31 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Fatsis. Oh, and he turns it over. Charge. 25 seconds now. USA trailing by 10. I don't think they'll hold it for one shot. I think they'll attack the basket. And Vasilopoulos comes in for Fatsis. Panyanis Vasilopoulos, the youngster, comes in. 17 seconds, so the U.S. will hold it for one shot. Wade possibly penetrate, kick it out to James or Heinrich in the corner. Drives in all the way, and it gets out to Spanoulis, who has enough time. Drives in and scores for Greece. How's that for a finish to the third quarter, which has been owned by Greece? No question about it. These guys believe they can pull a stunner. 77-65 in Athens, Piraeus, all over the place. They are loving it because Greece are leading by 12 points in the Battle of the Unbeatens. The winner goes to the final of the FIBA World Championship. Well, we talked about this FIBA World Championship having four or five teams that might win it all. I think when Tony Parker went out for France, that obviously killed their chances. But everybody who knew anything about international basketball knew Greece, the United States, Argentina, and Spain were quality teams that were good enough to win this world title. The United States had the wind in their sails for a while in the first half, went up by 12 points, but Greece fought back to lead at halftime, and here they are, all these Greek fans watching, leading. And some of the fans, some of the American fans here with their families, families of players and what have you, it's a nervous time for them because they don't want to see the United States return home without a gold medal. And it's just been a case of Greeks playing fantastic basketball, passing it, good defense, sitting back in the zone, choosing their moments. And the confidence has grown. But do not count out Team USA. We've got a long way to go in this one. Penetration, drive, Dwayne Wade puts up a wild one and it goes in and draws the foul. And Greece asking, where was the foul? And very cheap foul called on Papaloukas, I think. If you look at that one again. Takes it to a 10-point lead. Good start to the fourth quarter, Dwayne Wade. He makes it, so the U.S. 19 of 32, 59% from the free throw line, leading 77-68, our Greece. Dekuda's battling for position. He's a big body, he's strong. Guarded by Joe Johnson. Spanoulis in the game. Greece shooting 6 of 12 from three-point range. Most of those in the third quarter. There were 2 of 8 in the first half from the arc. Tikoudis sets the pick. Kukuzius for 3. Count it! And they are falling right now, 7 of 13 for Greece. 9 minutes to go, Greece on top by 12. And the defense and the United States, because the ball was hit over, and Heinrich saw an opportunity for an alley-oop. I think people in the crowd thought it may have been over and back. Then he put it up to James. The foul on Kukuzius. I'll tell you what, basketball is going to be the topic of conversation in Japan for the rest of this FIBA World Championship after this game. This has been a phenomenal contest. Both teams playing really hard. Look at this arena. It is jam-packed. I'm sure most people here expecting the United States to win against Greece. If you would have read the headlines, you would have seen the papers here. It was all about Team USA. A little bit of ignorance about the rest of the world game, particularly Greece. It's been a great contest so far. Dekoudis. And great defense from Dwayne Wade. Turns it over to the United States. 11-point lead. Heinrich pulls up for 3. Off the back of the rim. Long rebound. LeBron James. Anthony into the lane. And it goes to Wade for the two-handed dunk. Wade. 80-71. At some point, we're going to see full court pressure from the U.S. When are they going to apply it? Spanoulis. Kukuzius for 3, missed badly. Dekoudis chases it down and throws it out of bounds off Wade. What a terrific play. Two-handed jam from Dwayne Wade. When he gets going to the basket, I don't know who stops him. And the entry pass, and it's got to be a three-point play opportunity for Kukuzius. Defensive breakdown from the United States on the inbounds pass. I wasn't in Greece when they won the European title in 87, which changed basketball forever in Europe with Panayotis Yannakis on the floor. But I suspect the feeling in the arena that day was something to what we're feeling right now here in Saitama. The way these Greeks are playing, 83-71, less than 8 minutes to go in the game. Anthony from the corner for three. He is doing it for the U.S. 3 of 6, 27 points. Carmelo Anthony. Some of the other players like Pau Gasol of Spain have come into the arena to watch this game. This is the place to be. All of Turkey here, all of these teams. Theo Papaloukas, shot clock. Down to two, he goes up and scores with his left hand. Back to an 11-point lead for Greece. Battier, Wade for three, good, count it. What courage Dwayne Wade's shown. I'll tell you, those shots are harder to make when you're down than when you're leading. Anthony and Wade, the two captains, James, the other captain, those two guys hitting the three-pointers. Kukuzius drives, draws the foul from Battier. Don't understand why Dwight Howard hasn't played as much in the second half. He was fantastic in the first half. 10 points, 4 of 6 inside the arc. 2 of 3 from the line, 7 rebounds. And the Americans, and I think possibly a lot of the Japanese here supporting the U.S. And that takes it back to a 9-point lead. Paul, James. Cross court it goes. Anthony for three. Battier with the rebound. Chris Paul for three. And the U.S. keeping it alive. And now Greece have a chance to run. Spanoulis. He'll pull it back out. Chris Paul on Spanoulis. Over to Papaloukas. Greece trying to control the tempo. Papaloukas. Guarded by LeBron. 7 seconds on the shot clock. Spanoulis. He's waiting. Puts up the three. Rims out. The battle for the board, and it's Carmelo Anthony with the board. Less than 6 minutes to go. Greece leading by 9. Diamantidis trying to stay with Anthony, who goes up. Battle misses. Now Greece can run. Papaloukas. Spanoulis goes up strong, and it's blocked by the U.S., but the foul called, and the basket counts. It's goaltending. Dwayne Wade, Spanoulis. Whew, catch your breath, folks. 88-77, Greece leading the United States. 5:39 to play. Spanoulis, the big star with Panathinaikos last season in Greece and in the EuroLeague, misses the three-point play opportunity. He'll be teaming up with Yao Ming next year with the Houston Rockets. Spanoulis. LeBron James guarded by Papaloukas. Wanting to get into the lane, get a good shot. LeBron kicks it over to Paul, and it goes out of bounds. 5:21 left in the game. And Greece lead it by 11. And it's interesting, a contrast of styles for Greece. In the first half, it was Shortsenidis who really turned the game in their favor, and he really hasn't played since going to the bench early in the second half. with those three fouls. Theo drives, Kukuzius, corner, off the rim. The USA have a chance to run. 3-on-2 break. Wade over to James. Great composure by the U.S. 4:45. Papaloukas. Bounce pass it goes and blocked by Team USA. Battier, his third block of the game. And the foul called on Papaloukas. Shane Battier's defense. I think the block was by Battier, and if it was, he has three. Timeout, 4:32. Greece lead it 88-79 over Team USA. Trying to pick up what's being said inside the American huddle. The United States of America lost in the quarterfinals. They didn't win in 1998. Settled for the bronze there. That was a team that was supposed to be full of NBA players, but because of the labor dispute in America with the NBA players, they stayed home. And at the 2000 Olympics in Sydney, the Americans won gold. They were pushed by Lithuania and France in the gold medal game. Lithuania in the semifinal. At the last World Championships, the USA lost in the quarterfinals. And at the Olympics in Athens, they finished with a bronze medal. And James, strong move inside. It's the closest they've been for a long time, 88-81. Greece in front. Expect the defensive pressure, and Schwarzenegger has also come back in for Team USA. For Greece, excuse me. Schwarzenegger in the game. And he gets the entry pass, and LeBron James fouls Schwarzenegger. And I think that's five fouls, so Schwarzenegger may have free throws. All those afternoons at the gym, shooting free throws. And Schwarzenegger knocks it down. You know the pressure is coming from the USA. So you got Spanoulis on the floor. This is the second one. Spanoulis, Papaloukas, and Diamantidis. Dwayne Wade spins, gets in the lane. Over to James. How does he hang in the air like that? It's unreal. LeBron James and the foul, the travel. And one ref is going to overrule the other. And he's going to call the foul on Spanoulis. Greece not actually in the bonus yet, or the USA, so the next foul from Greece and they will be in the bonus. It's an 8-point lead, 3.5 minutes to go in the game. Johnson in the corner, Wade goes up, misses the dunk.
How did he miss it? Papaloukas and Diamantidis, and already the signs of the pressure. Will the American pressure start to pay dividends? 3:20 to go. James drives strong to the basket. LeBron James explodes to the hoop, 89-83. The U.S. fans on their feet, but so are the Greeks. It's an incredible atmosphere in Saitama. Spanoulis drives and he scores. 2:50 to go in the game, 91-83, Greece leading. In the corner, Kurt Heinrich for three, count it! The USA are coming back. It's a 5-point lead. Can Greece hold on? You've got to feel like we're watching history here. I'm not sure this game has ever had an equal in the World Championship. It is phenomenal. Baby, it's Schwarzenegger, an intentional unsportsmanlike foul called against Kurt Heinrich because he wasn't playing the ball. And that means Schwarzenegger gets free throws and they'll also keep the ball. That's the second time Kurt Heinrich has been hit with an unsportsmanlike foul. It's a tough rule to get used to, a very tough rule. A lot of players here have struggled. Timeout on the floor, Greece with a 5-point lead. Well, Diamantidis plays at Panathinaikos. They've played in a lot of big games. He's played in a lot of big games also with Greece. Don't forget Diamantidis hitting that three-pointer last year against France in the semifinal at the buzzer. Greece have done this without Nikos Zisis, their outstanding guard from Benetton Treviso, who has those three broken bones in his face. He's at the end of the bench, pulling his team on. And the Lithuanians are starting to side with the Greeks here in the crowd. Schwarzenegger misses the free throw. Schwarzenegger is now 2 of 5 from the line. He's been shooting 60% in the tournament and misses both of them, so that's a big opportunity that goes amiss for the Greeks. Dwight Howard not in the game. It's a team that can apply a lot of pressure right now for Team USA. 17 seconds on the shot clock, 2 minutes to go. Spanoulis open for three. Oh, he hits it! Vasilis Spanoulis, 1:58 to go, is back to an 8-point lead. Good defense by Papaloukas. The USA finally looks stunned. It's not over, but this is definitely, you got to feel Greece's game to win. Joe Johnson, LeBron James, over to Wade in the corner for three, off the rim, battle for the board, and it's Greece, 1.5 minutes to go. Greece, improbably, unbelievably, incredulously, are leading 94-86 over Team USA. This simply was not in the plan for the USA when they put their team together. the steal. Up ahead to Wade, who goes in for the layup. Full court pressure. Papaloukas. 105 to go. 6-point lead. Long time to go. Can the Americans come up with another steal? LeBron James guarding Diamantinas, who penetrates, kicks it over to Kukuzias from the corner. Long rebound, it goes out to Greece. Spanoulis, 48 seconds left. The United States are going to have to start thinking about fouling, and they do. They foul Spanoulis. And they fouled a good free throw shooter. In this championship, he's been shooting 90% from the free throw line. Greece lead it by 6. Oh, and he missed it. The pressure. The pressure is telling on Greece. They've missed 3 straight free throws. Can they hold off the Americans? That takes it up to 7. 44.8 seconds to go. The Americans need points, and they need them quickly. Time is the enemy. Heinrich from the corner. Nails the 3! Here comes the pressure. And Kukuzius is fouled now. That Heinrich three-pointer cuts the lead to 4, and the Americans are complaining that Heinrich got hammered by Schwarzenegger, and there was no call in the corner. And Heinrich has to come out, because with that, that foul was his 5th. So that is a big one, because he's one of their best shooters. Kukuzius makes the first one. Greece know better than anybody the games aren't over until they're over, because they've come back so many times, even in this tournament. So there's a long way to go. Kukuzius makes the second one, 97-91. Back to a 6-point lead. Fatsis in the game. Kukuzius, Papaloukas. LeBron James drives, strong move, battle for the board. James gets the rebound and puts it up and in. 27 seconds to go, the United States trailing by 4. Fatsis has to get the ball inbounds. Turnover. The United States, the pressure defense. Failure to execute is not something that we've seen much of today. Carmelo Anthony for 3. Rebound, he shot an air ball, and he's fouled. Fatsis gets the rebound. Oh, gosh. What in the world? Carmelo Anthony has been so good today. But on that one, he missed it with an air ball. Anthony has 27 points, hasn't scored in a while. Spanoulis with 22 leads Greece. Fatsis makes the first one. Turkey watching this game. Don't see them celebrating too much, seeing their rivals beating Team USA. 22 seconds to play. The United States down by 6. LeBron James right down the lane. It goes up for the two-handed jam. 4-point game. Kukuzius. And you've got to believe that if Greece can hit their free throws, this is their game. 15.6 seconds remain. The United States rolling through the tournament, winning Group D, beating Australia, beating Germany, and now they face the European champions in Greece. Lead them 99-95. Timeout. No timeout has been called, but the Red Foxes are ready to go. Timeout was called. Mike Krzyzewski, I think, saying he did not want a timeout. Possibly after the free throws, I don't know. Team USA saying they wanted the timeout after the free throw. Mike D'Antoni talking to the commissioner, trying to get an explanation. D'Antoni politely asking why couldn't they have the timeout after the free throw, which makes more sense. It's been a class effort by Greece, or rather by Team USA in this tournament. Kukuzius putting him up, makes the free throw, 100. Greece have put 100 points on the board against the United States. 15.6 seconds to go. Will it be enough? 6-point lead, it's a 2-possession game. LeBron James pulls up for three, no good. Greece are gonna upset the United States. The clock is ticking down, 3 seconds. Chris Paul, Greece has stunned the United States of America. Theo Papaloukas kicks the ball up in the stands. Greece has shown the balance in the international game. They've won the European title. They've beaten the United States 101-95. Celebrations underway here in the Saitama Arena for them and their fans. You can better believe it than in Greece. People are going nuts. It will be a national holiday in Athens. They won't be going to work there, baby. The United States and Carmelo Anthony, their brilliant run at the World Championship, has been brought to a halt here at the FIBA World Championship. Greece, as the American players walk off the court, the Americans are stunned. They've been a class act in this FIBA World Championship. They've really done America proud. There's no question about it. But what they found out is that there are some good teams out there. And I don't think for a minute the United States ever doubted they wouldn't win the gold. But I also don't think for a minute that they ever didn't respect their opponents. It's just the game got away from them, and they have come out here, and they have done the business. Panayotis Yiannakis goes over and talks to Anton Jameson, the Greek players. The party is on in Athens, and questions now will be asked of Jerry Colangelo, Mike Krzyzewski, and all those Team USA players who have seen their team fail to win the gold medal. The best they'll be able to do now is get a bronze. And LeBron doesn't want to take home LeBron's. Greece have done it. Mikhail Kukuzius hugging Theo Papaloukas. I think they're a mixture of sweat and tears because it's been an emotional ride for Greece. It started after the Olympics in 2004 when they failed to win a medal. They rededicated themselves to excellence. They went to Belgrade. They won the European title. They've just done the business here. They've carried that momentum. They've added Shortsenidis. He was such an influential player today with 14 points. Spanoulis, Papaloukas, Panayotis Yiannakis. If you didn't believe it, well, you believe it now. This game is equal all over the world. Styles are different. Rules may be a little bit different. But the one thing that's a certainty, there is quality basketball in Greece, all over Europe, in Africa, South America. And Greece are gonna party. I don't know if they'll be able to play the final. I guarantee you those boys aren't going to bed tonight. Argentina looking on. The United States have left the court. And all I can say is commiserations to them. They'll have to come back now and play the loser, Spain's game against Argentina. Ladies and gentlemen, please stay tuned for the next game between. There are the stats. But for the final time, the United States, those high hopes of bringing back the gold have been dashed. They fall to Greece 101-95. Vasilis Panoulis with 22 points leads Greece 15 points for Mikhailis Kikouzias. But it was a team effort, as always, for the Greeks. For the United States, Carmelo Anthony's 27 points weren't enough. 19 for Dwayne Wade, 17 for LeBron James. Those three, the captains. Inside Tama, 101 to Greece. They're into the final, 95 to USA. They'll play in the bronze medal game.